like a second home for many of us, thanks to the custodian of the two holy mosques, King Salman bin Abdulaziz, for providing us this opportunity. Our embassies in this regards have played a very crucial role in facilitating our stay in the kingdom, and we are thankful to them. On an occasion like this, where the Indian diaspora has gathered to celebrate Sir Sayyid Day, I think no one can be better suited as the chief guest other than the Ambassador of India to Saudi Arabia, His Excellency Dr. Ausaf Sayeed. Dr. Ausaf Sayeed is a career diplomat belonging to the Indian Foreign Service 1989 batch. He holds a Master of Science and PhD in Geology from Osmania University in Hyderabad, India, and an advanced diploma in Arabic from the American University in Cairo. He is a competent Toastmaster and recipient of the YGK Murthy Gold Medal from Osmania University. Dr. Sayeed has handled different areas of work in his 30 years of diplomatic service, including political, economic, consular, and cultural works, besides Hajj management. Dr. Sayeed has worked in different capacities in the Indian Foreign Service, such as High Commissioner of India to Seychelles, Consul General of India in Chicago, Ambassador of India to Yemen, Consul General of India in Jeddah, and at different positions in the Indian diplomatic missions in Cairo, Riyadh, Doha, and Copenhagen. He has also served as the Joint Secretary overseeing the West African Division in the Ministry of External Affairs and as the Regional Passport Officer in Hyderabad. Dr. Sayeed has published 3 books, one on geology and 2 on Indian art and culture. He also has compiled and edited the Urdu book Kulliyat-e-Awaz Sayeed, which comprises of the entire literary works of his father. Dr. Sayeed is married to Madame Farha Sayeed, an accomplished egg sculptor and artist, and the couple is blessed with 3 handsome sons. And with this couplet, I would like to invite His Excellency to the podium. Chand bhi haira, darya bhi pareshani mein hai. Chand bhi haira, darya bhi pareshani mein hai. Aks kiska hai ki itni roshni paani mein hai. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome His Excellency Dr. Ausaf Sayeed.
Engineer Fakir Al Shahwaf, CEO of Al Bhawani Group. Janab Engineer Sayed Muhammad Mutayyib Saab, President of the Aligarh Alumni Association of Riyadh. Mr. Engineer Humayun Hashmi, Vice President, and Dr. Muhammad Abdul Farah, General Secretary. Ladies and gentlemen, distinguished guests, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Khawateen o Hazrat, aaj hum yahan jadeed Hindustan ke ek azim shakhsiyat Sir Sayyid Ahmed Khan ki khiraj tahseen pesh karne ke liye aaye hain. Aaj unka 202 yom e paidaish hai jisko hum Sir Sayyid Day ke naam se manate hain. Jaisa ki kaha jata hai aur jaisa ki humne abhi dekha ki itni sari young ladkiyan, they were invited on the stage and they were honored. So there was a saying, and I'll say it in Urdu, ki jaisa ki ek kawat hai ki agar aap kisi aurat ko taleem dilwate hain to aap ek kumbe ko taleem dete hain, aur agar aap kisi ladki ko taleem dete hain to aap mustaqbil ko taleem dete hain. Sir Sayyid Ahmed Khan की शख्सियत को भी एक खातून ने अरासा है. वो कोई और नहीं बल्कि उनकी वालिदा अजीज उन्निसा. वो शी वाज द वन हु हैड इंस्पायर्ड एंड मोल्डेड हिज पर्सनालिटी. और उनकी वालिदा, इन्होंने एक्चुअली जाती दिलचस्पी ली और बड़ी सख्त निगरानी में उनकी परवरिश की, entirely focusing on his education, and that led to his development of his multifaceted personality. Sir Sayyid Ahmed Khan ne 1875 mein, jaisa kaha gaya, Anglo-Mohammedan Oriental College ki buniyad rakhi, jo aage chal ke Aligarh Muslim University bani, aur shayad ye sare एशिया में, साउथ एशिया में खास करके, दिस मस्ट बी द फर्स्ट मुस्लिम यूनिवर्सिटी इन द एंटायर साउथ एशिया. अलीगढ़ मुस्लिम यूनिवर्सिटी उसके फौरन बाद चंद ही अरसों में एक जदीद तालीम और साइंस और साइंटिफिक सोच की मुसलमानों की जो खोज थी, टू हैव अ मॉडर्न एजुकेशन और साइंटिफिक थिंकिंग, दैट बिकेम द हब एंड सिम्बल ऑफ ऑल दिस थॉट प्रोसेस. यहाँ हमें याद रखने के चाहिए कि अलीगढ़ मुस्लिम यूनिवर्सिटी हिंदुस्तान के उन 7 ओल्ड कदीम यूनिवर्सिटीज़ में से हैं. एंड इफ़ यू रिमेंबर, द फर्स्ट वन was the Sriram College, which was established in 1818. And then it was followed by the University of Roorkee, which later on became the first IIT of India, Indian Institute of Roorkee, which was in 1847. Then three big universities were established in India in the year 1857. One was the University of Mumbai, another was the University of Madras, and third was the University of Calcutta. Then followed the two great universities, of course, the Aligarh Muslim University and Allahabad University in 1875. Thereafter, of course, followed the other two institutions, the Banaras Hindu University in 1916, followed by the Usmani University in 1918. Aligarh Muslim University ke bani, Sir Sayed Ahmed Khan, koi aam ماہر تعلیم تاریخ دان مصنف یا جورس نہیں تھے بلکہ ایک غیر معمولی اصلاح پسند سیکولر قوم پرست اور جدید ہندوستان کے سب سے اہم معمار تھے انہوں نے زور دے کر یہ کہا کہ تمام ہندوستانی خاص طور پہ مسلمان تعلیم اور سائنسی علم خاص کو حاصل کریں تاکہ ان کی ترقی یقینی بنے This was very important for this message of Sir Sayed Ahmed Khan to the Muslims at a time when India had just emerged from the colonial rule of more than 200 years, that they should focus on the modern education, the scientific education, develop the thinking of pragmatism, be better integrated in the society, because for him, education was the only way in which the Muslim community could move forward, rather than remaining cocooned in their own traditional manners, in their own traditional ways of education. Mahatma Gandhi ne Sir Sayed Ahmed Khan ko messenger of education ka khitab diya. And yakinan, this title by Mahatma Gandhi to Sir Sayed Ahmed Khan as the messenger of education was indeed a very fitting tribute to this great personality. And another quality of Sir Sayed Ahmed Khan was his championing the cause of Hindu-Muslim unity. What Sir Sayed Ahmed Khan said, and I quote it in Urdu, is that hum Hindu or Musliman ایک ہی فصل کھاتے ہیں ایک ہی دریاؤں سے پانی پیتے ہیں اور اسی ہوا کو سانس لیتے ہیں حقیقت یہ ہے کہ ہندو اور مسلمان خوبصورت دلہن کی دو آنکھیں ہیں اور اگر ان دو آنکھوں میں سے کسی ایک آنکھ کو بھی نقصان پہنچتا ہے تو دلہن کی شکل بگڑ سکتی ہے یعنی کہ ہمارے ملک کی شکل بگڑ سکتی ہے This was indeed a message, and I would like to translate for our distinguished guest from here. Sir Sayed Ahmed Khan equated the two dominant communities of India, Hindus and the Muslims, as the eyes, two eyes of a bride, a beautiful bride, who he equated as the country India. And he said, because of anything, if harm comes to one eye, the whole bride would lose her beauty, and the country would get affected. خواتین و حضرات میرا تعلق حیدرآباد سے ہے اور حیدرآباد کا ہمیشہ ہی سے علی گڑھ سے بہت گہرا تعلق رہا ہے وہاں کے تمام نظام علی گڑھ مسلم یونیورسٹیز کے لیے ان کی علی گڑھ یونیورسٹی کی دیکھ بھال کے لیے علی گڑھ مسلم کی ترقی کے لیے بڑی فراغ دلی سے گرانٹس دیتے تھے گرانٹس انہیں دیا کرتے تھے حیدرآباد کے نظام ایک طویل عرصے تک علی گڑھ مسلم یونیورسٹی کے چانسلر رہے اور اس کیپیسٹی میں وہ انہوں نے علی گڑھ یونیورسٹی وزٹ بھی کی اور کافی ایک قسم کا ایک انٹریکشن ایک سمجھیے فلو آف اسکالرلی آئیڈیاز واز دیر بٹوین علی گڑھ اینڈ حیدرآباد فلو آف اسکالرس انٹرچینج آف اسکالرس وچ آلسو لیڈ ایونچولی to the formation of the Usmania University in Hyderabad in 1918, as I mentioned. And it was the first vernacular university which was established in India with the medium of instruction as Urdu. And for this particular feat which was very unique in India, because all the while, of course, all the mediums of instruction of the universities were English, none other than the Rabindranath Tagore had sent a special message to Nizam of Hyderabad saying, yes, there is a language which is Urdu, which also our Sir Syed Ahmad Khan, which was very dear to him, and he also promoted the Urdu language as something which is inherent to the culture and ethos of Muslims in India. So this was something which was made possible also by this kind of flow of ideas which flew from north to the south and from Aligarh to Hyderabad. And indeed, the message of Sir Syed Ahmad Khan and his emphasis on education, and of course, his message of unity and brotherhood among the different communities and inclusive growth is as relevant in today's world as what as was relevant during his lifetime. Education, of course, was his prime pillar on which for which he is remembered. And again, education is not alien to Muslims. The first verse of the Holy Quran, the first message with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala conveyed to our Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam through Angel Jibril was Ikhra, read. It was not to go out or conquer land or to do trading or anything else. Everything followed later. The first thing was to read. And even our own Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, you can seek knowledge even if you have to go up to China. So that is the kind of emphasis our religion, Islam, has put on education and being educated and knowing and acquiring knowledge, knowing about cultures. This is indeed very, very important. And again, in the context of the kingdom and Saudi Arabia, we know that there has been a phenomenal exchange of ideas, exchange of people between the both sides from a long, long time, centuries. People have been visiting Hijaz for performing Hajj and Umrah. And in the modern context, our two countries are close to forming a strategic partnership. The Crown Prince had visited, His Royal Highness Prince Mohammed bin Salman had visited India in February this year, which was a return visit following the visit of Indian Prime Minister Shri Narendra Modi to Riyadh in 2016. Our Prime Minister of India is due to come end of this month again to Riyadh. It will be a visit which both countries are looking forward to. We as Indians would be very happy, and we are very glad to strengthen the hands of the kingdom, and to especially at a time when the kingdom is set to hold the presidency of the G20 starting from the 1st of December. All the Indian diaspora here, we have 2.6 million Indians as we are speaking, and all these Indian nationals have been contributing meaningfully to the restructuring and to the building of the new modern era Saudi Arabia. And as part of the Vision 2030, educational collaboration is again, and cultural and people-to-people cooperation is again one of the strong areas which we are working together. And I'm sure that there will be opportunities for meaningful exchanges between universities so that the Indian faculty can work and come and work here. They can come, there could be visiting faculties, perhaps there could be a time when there could be Indian students who could come and then spend a semester here. The South these students could go and spend semester in India. We are seriously working to bring about institutions of higher learning of repute from India to Saudi Arabia, because again we see that the perception of the kingdom has towards the education in India has also changed. There was a time when they were only looking towards the Western model of education, but now we can feel and see the perceive the kind of keenness it is being shown to have Indian institutions represented in the kingdom. We are talking to institutions such as the International School of Business and perhaps the IITs and IIMs to see, to explore the possibility of engagement in Saudi Arabia. And I'm also happy to learn from a senior Saudi functionary in the Ministry of Foreign Affairs that the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia has also instituted around 200 educational scholarships for Indian students who are residing in Saudi Arabia to pursue higher education in Saudi universities. And this is certainly going to have go a long way in helping our students. Plus, coupled with our initiative to have the Indian institutions also come here, I think sooner or later our students who so far do not have many opportunities after the fresh 10+2 would have enough opportunities and enough alternatives for them to pursue higher education here. And to mark this occasion as a fitting tribute to Sir Sayed Ahmed Khan, it is our bounden duty of all the persons, not just the alumni of Aligarians, to carry forward the message of Sir Sayed Ahmed Khan, to carry forward the Aligarian movement, which hinges on two primary things. One is education, scientific thinking, and pragmatism and modern thinking, but also at the same time to promote the inclusivity, promote the intercultural, interreligious harmony, and promote the brotherhood among different religions, different citizens, and different countries. With all these words, I once again congratulate all of you, all the alumni of Aligarh Muslim University, all the invited guests, and all the people who must be watching this program globally, a very, very, warm wishes on the Sir Sayed Ahmed Day. And thank you very much for inviting me and my wife, Jai Hind, and all the best.